Moving on to the sixth question in our math series, we have the question adding 1 to a number. Okay, so the problem statement is that they will give you a non-negative integer that is going to be represented in the form of an array of digits. That is, your input is going to be of the form like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3. That is a non-negative integer that is represented in the form of array of digits. Okay, so this is nothing but 123. Add 1 to the number and then display it. So the output must be what? 1, 2, 4. How? Because this number is basically nothing but 123. Add 1 to the number, I get 124. Okay, this is what you have to present as output. So this is a question. So what is a basic thing that actually strikes your mind when you see this question? It's just that, okay, they have given me an array of digits. So this array of digits is nothing but the digit itself, right? 1, 2, 3 is nothing but 123. So what I got, this is, let's go with the brute force approach first, okay? So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to convert this 1, 2, 3 into 123. And then it is so simple, I'll just add 1 to it, I will convert it into 124, and then I will again split this 124 into an array of digits as 1, 2, 4 and display as output. So this is what I'm going to be doing right now, okay? So how can I make convert this 1, 2, 3 to 123? I can run a for loop, right? I can basically run a for loop from, if this 1, 2, 3, I can run a for loop from 1 up till 3. Okay, so what I do is that for int i0, I is less than, so suppose that this is a, okay, and it's a vector. Know that vector and array are actually, you know, same, but that vector is more easy to use when compared to an array. Okay, so for instance, i0, I is less than a dot size i++. So I'm traversing the entire array. And then let me have some int k is equal to 0. Okay. So now k is equal to 10 into k plus a of I. So what do you think will happen here? What will happen is basically that firstly it's 1, 2, 3. Okay. So in this 1, 2, 3, I will have this. First, this is i0, this is 1, and this is 2. So at i0, I'm getting 1 as my number. So k is equal to 10 into k plus a of I. So k at I is equal to 0, k will be 0 only. That is 10 into 0, k's initial value is 0, plus a of I. So what is a of I here? It is 1. So 10 into 0 plus 1, 0 plus 1, which is 1. Next, at I is equal to 1, the iterator is going to go till 2. So now k will be equal to 10 into 1. What is the value of k here? K right now has changed to 1. Okay, k's value right now is 1. So this value is getting used here. Okay, 10 into 1 plus 1. So which is 10, sorry, plus 2. A of 1, right? A of 1 is what? 2. So 10 into 1 plus 2, which is equal to 10 plus 2. That is 12. So can you notice 1, 2 is now changed to 12. First we had only 1, that was 1. Now on second iteration it become 1, 2. Now, on third iteration, on moving to the last element of the array, k will be equal to 10 into, what is the value of k right now? It is 12. So 12 plus last most element, a of I. A of I is, a of 2 is 3. So it is 120 plus 3, which is 123. So can you notice 1, 2, 3, I have changed it successfully into 123 and it's now stored in the variable k. Okay. So now what can I do? As simple. I got the number, so this integer I can simply add 1. No, so int t is equal to what? K plus 1. So on adding k plus 1, what will happen? T will store the value of 124. So we have covered this step. The conversion step is done and then the addition step is done. This step is also done. So we are pending with this step. Now 124 must be split to 1, 2, 4. So how can I possibly do that? Is that it's actually the reverse process of this. Okay, we converted the array of integers into a single digit. Right now we'll be converting this digit into an array of digits, so the vice versa process. How can I possibly do that? Is that now the value stored in t. Okay, let me run a while loop. while t is not equal to 0. Okay, so when while t is not equal to 0, int r is equal to t mod 10. And then let me actually initialize an array of vector, okay? Vector of int b. Let me initialize this. So b of and int I is equal to 0. I'll explain this with a code walkthrough very shortly. Is equal to r, and then t is equal to t by 10. So what I'm doing here is basically that I'm trying to split the number, okay? So I'm trying to split 124 into 1, 2, 4 from here to here. This is the code for that. So what I'm doing is that I'm initializing an array vector of int b, okay? So right now this 1, 2, 4 will be stored in the vector b, and I'm initializing int I as 0, okay? So now what will happen is that while t is not equal to 0, int r is equal to t mod 10. So what is t? T is nothing but 124. So what is t mod 10? T mod 10 is nothing but the remainder you get when t is divided by 10. What is that? That is 4. Okay, so now r will be storing the value of what? 4. B of I plus plus, I'm giving it as r. So first what will happen is that b of, what is the initial value of I is 0. Okay, so b of 0 will be initialized as 4, and then the value of I will get incremented. So right now the I becomes 1. So b of 0 is 4 right now. Okay, and then t is equal to t by 10. So t is equal to t by 10 will land up with what? We'll get the quotient, right? It is 12. So t will store the value of 12 right now. So initially the array b is right now having the value of 4. 0, 1, 2, and firstly we'll get the value of 4. Then what will happen is that again t is not equal to 0, right? So t is still 12, which is not equal to 0. So what I do is r is equal to again t mod 10. So what is t here? It is 12 mod 10. So 12 mod 10 is 2. Modulus is nothing but what is the remainder you get when 12 is divided by 10? You get 2, right? Then b of I plus plus. So what is the value of I right now? 1. So b of 1 will be equal to what? R. R is 2 here. So b of 1 is 2. B of 1 is 2. We got that. So now I will get incremented to give what? 2. From 1, I plus plus, we get 2. So first always remember, b of I plus plus is equal to R. We'll first take the value of original I and initialize it with the R, and then only you're going to increment it, okay? And then only the value of I plus plus takes place. Next, again, t is equal to t by 10. So this is the first step, this is the second step, this is your third step. So t is equal to t by 10 is what? It is going to be 1, okay? So this is my very first case, this is my second case. Now moving on to the third case, 1. Again, 1 is not equal to 0, right? While t is not equal to 0, so yeah, 1 is not equal to 0, so what am I going to do? R is equal to t mod 10. So 1 mod 10. 1 mod 10, remainder is 1 only. And b of I plus plus is equal to r. So what is the value of r here? 1. Okay. B of I plus plus, I's value right now is 2. So b of 2 will be given the value of 1. So b of 2 will be given the value of 1. So what can you notice here? Instead of 1, 2, 4, we have actually received 4, 2, 1, which is exact opposite of 124. Okay, so now and then t will be equal to t by 10, which is 1 by 10. You get the remainder of, you get the quotient as 0, right? So right now, t is 0, so this while loop will break right now. So at the end of this while loop, what did you land up with? We landed up with d is equal to 4, 2, 1, which is the exact opposite of 124, right? So when you get a vector, you can actually easily reverse a vector, okay? That is why I'll mostly suggest vectors in place of arrays, because in arrays we'll again have to run a for loop to reverse it and something like that, whereas for vectors you have some predefined functions that you can just make use of automatically to do reverse operations, swap operations, something like that. I have another module for vectors. If you haven't checked it out, please do check it out. So now, we have this 1, 2, 4. So right now I can simply reverse the value of b, right? By using b, reverse of from b dot begin till b dot end. So this is going to practically reverse the entire array. So from 4, 2, 1, you will land up with 1, 2, 4. So we have actually got the answer, okay? So this was our first step, this was our second step, and finally this is the third step. So comprising all these three things, we will land up with the solution, right? So